As we approach month four, your final month of the New You lifestyle, what's most important is learning how to stay ready. And staying ready means you are always prepared because you are naturally always planning ahead and two steps ahead. So I want you to imagine for a second, you're going to the beach, you live about 45 minutes away, which means you need to have everything with you because if you forget something, you can't really go back to get it in a timely manner. So you know that you need some beach towels, of course, so you can dry off from the ocean if you get wet. You need your beach chairs so that, you know, you can sit and relax. You may even bring a volleyball, some sort of ball to play on the beach, suntan lotion so you don't get burnt. And lastly, you may even be bringing a cooler with some ice, drinks, fruits, some food to eat while you're there. So you know what you need to make your beach day a success, and you thought ahead of time, and you probably even thought the night before what you needed to have prepared and ready to go so that you didn't go unprepared. You didn't just wake up and just figure it out really quick in 2 seconds and leave the house. And our life is all about being prepared and staying ready because life gets busy, and we can blame not having time and not having things readily available, which is why you can't stay on track of your habits. But in reality, it all comes down to choices and effort, and you need to choose to always think ahead. You need to put in the effort to be prepared and to be ahead of time and have a backup plan when things go off course. And the meal plan table is there for a reason because it shows you and teaches you how to create your meals, whether it's at home or you're out and about or you're on the go. Studying it and memorizing the meal plan table, when you memorize it and you know the plate guideline, you can always vision the table wherever you are. And it allows you to make your meals with the 9-20 in mind. You can always ask yourself, do I have my protein? Do I have my carbs? Do I have my vegetables? Am I eating too much fats? You know by now that you always need protein at every meal. Carbs are super easy to get in. So whenever you are cooking home or you're preparing home, or you're on the go traveling and doing things that are busy, the one thing you always need to plan ahead and think of is, how can I get in my protein? And when I say protein, it has to be true protein. And that's, of course, what's listed on the meal plan table. You can see all your true protein sources. And if you're not always ready with ways to get in your protein, then your health and your fitness goals will always slack because it's so easy to slack on protein because it involves the most effort and the most thinking, and it's the least readily available macronutrient. So there are always a few ways to stay ready. And if you are always ready, you will never fail. And this habit will become part of your life. And if you find ways to balance all of your macronutrients forever, you will be able to stay healthy and feel good and manage your weight forever. So having protein readily available at all times, especially when you're home, is key, and even when you're on the go. So when you plan your week, you need to think of ways to prep your protein choices ahead of time, whether it's grilling, baking some chicken in bulk, cooking some ground turkey in bulk for taco bowls and wraps, and you could make bowls out of them. Same with chicken. So whether it's pre-made chicken or just chicken in a can for the days that you're in a hurry, you wanna have protein in your house. Cooking your protein in bulk can take about 35 to 45 minutes for the whole week. That's it. And you want to learn what habits that you slack on the most, and those are the habits you need to find a routine with so that it becomes part of your day so that you're always ready. Now, once you commit to always having cooked protein in your fridge or having it in your freezer at all times, you then want to figure out your arsenal of quick protein options. Quick protein options that you always want to have readily available, especially when you're on the go, would be protein powder, protein bars, tuna packets, plain yogurts, beef and turkey, the turkey sticks, just to name a few little things, right? Overnight oats can be made in advance with just adding some protein to it. And those are always good ways to have meals, you know, ahead of time that have protein. And I want to share some tips and tricks of just always making sure you have protein on hand with whole foods and also good and better options. What do you do when you're out, right? This requires more thought and more effort. Why? Well, it's super easy to just go to a drive-thru, get something quick to eat, go into 7-Eleven, get a bagel, get a muffin, something fast, like nuts and chips, right? Those aren't full meals first, and they're also not filled with protein at all. So you don't have a sufficient amount of protein. It's very easy to go to a pizzeria to grab a slice of pizza. The easy stuff always includes mostly carbs and fats with very little protein. But how do you feel when you have meals that are super carb heavy and fat loaded with little protein? You're typically tired, bloated, feeling extra heavy and inflamed. So you already see the difference in how you feel with a balance of protein, carbs, and fats. So would you agree that it's worth the effort that goes into just making sure that you could get in your protein 90% of the time? So when you're out, you need to have protein as the main focal point, right? So how can I get in enough protein, right? That needs to be your question. Create your meal and choose the place that you're gonna go eat at with protein in mind first. Because you can find a salad at any restaurant or pizzeria and most delis and just add chicken to it, or steak, or shrimp. And you can grab a piece of fruit so you have some carbs. And now you're all covered. You have a salad with chicken, you have your veggies, and you have fruit, which is your carbs. And you can go to build your own locations like Chipotle, Mediterranean spots that allows you to build your own meal. So you can make your own balance of protein, carbs, veggies with rices, and of course protein. Most supermarkets have pre-made fresh hot foods like chicken, steaks, veggies, rice, pastas that you can create your own meal. Whole Foods is one of my favorite places to go whenever I'm traveling because you can choose any of their hot foods and create a nice, healthy, balanced lunch. And they're also filled with a lot of flavor, so it's not just boring chicken and broccoli. It's flavorful. Now, whenever you are ordering out, the chances of the protein being enough is not always in your control. So when this happens, you always want to be aware and make up for it when you get home or travel with some sort of supplementation. And you can have a shake when you get home, you can have a bar, you can even have some yogurt. My go-to is mug cake with cocoa whip. I mean, who would say no to mug cake? I'm not sure. It's my protein powder. It puffs up as cake. It's amazing. So when you're aware of foods that you didn't get in enough of that day, you just need to know that you need to make up for it later on and do your best that you can. There are times that I'm at a place and they only have breaded chicken or they have chicken smothered in sauce. And I know it's not the end of the world, but instead I'll balance it out with either more veggies rather than getting breaded chicken with more carbs and more fats. So you just have to be conscious of what is on your plate because you know the meal plan table, you know what your foods are made up of. And eating out shouldn't be 90% of your week. You want to limit your meals eating out as much as possible because having control over what you are eating is what's going to leave you feeling your best. The foods being cooked out in public places use different oils, tons of salt, a lot of hidden ingredients. They aren't always the best for our health overall, but again, it's gonna be something that you do. Eating out every single day is never recommended. And even if I can eat out every day and it's clean food, I still feel the effects of it. And of course, sometimes that happens when I'm away, I'm on vacation, I'm eating out more than normal. I always feel so much better though once I get home and I eat my own foods. And it's okay to eat out, and it's not something that I would tell you not to do because I do it. But I wouldn't recommend it for a majority of your meals because at the end of the day, you don't know how the food is being cooked. And eating out, in my opinion, should be more of a social thing rather than a must do because you're just swamped for time because you're just super busy and you need to grab something quickly, right? Because there are always ways for you to stay ready and to stay prepared no matter how busy you are. And it all comes down to putting in that little bit of time and that little bit of effort and having that arsenal of protein options with you at all times and thinking ahead. Not going throughout the day saying, oh, I forgot to eat, because that's just not a good enough of an excuse anymore. So let's quickly review some ways that you can always add protein to your meals, even if they don't typically match the meal plan table or if you're cooking for your child. How can you eat the same thing but adjust it accordingly to your goals and what your body needs, all while being creative and eating with everybody else, right? So I do want to mention that 25 to 20 grams, you want 20 to 25 grams of protein 4 times per day, or about 4 ounces of protein 4 times a day. That's really where you should be when it comes to protein. And then obviously this will vary a little bit depending on the person, But it is safe to say that unless you weigh 100 pounds, you shouldn't be eating less than 100 grams of protein daily. So my recommendation is to weigh out 4 ounces of chicken and other meats so you can see the correct portion sizes. And I'm sure you've actually done this by now when we were learning about tracking. Because I find many people make their protein size super small, which in the end just leaves them more hungry. And there are so many ways for you to just be more consistent as long as you weigh it out ahead of time and give yourself the idea of what it's supposed to look like. So I want to go into some ways for you to get creative with some meals, especially if you have kids and you're just want to eat what's around. And say you're making grilled cheese for your kids. Well, you can have grilled cheese, just add chicken to it, right? If you have soups, add chicken, add beef, add shrimp. If your kids want quesadillas, have the quesadillas, add meat to it. If your kids want pasta, add a meat sauce, have some meatballs with it. A bagel, fantastic. You need some eggs, maybe a protein shake on the side. Same with a muffin. Have a protein shake on the side. Have it with some yogurt. You can do the same thing with peanut butter and jelly or pancakes. Have a protein shake on the side or add protein powder to your pancakes. There's so many ways for you to have meals that you enjoy, but you just have to get creative and add something to the meal so that you're just not eating a whole meal filled with carbs. So when people say, I don't want to cook for me and my family, why would you be doing that? You don't have to do that. But you do want to say, okay, this is what my family's eating. How can I make it better? How can I make it balanced? How can I have my meals be balanced for my kids? Because at the end of the day, we're not eating rabbit food. And I'm not telling you to eat kale salad, and I'm not telling you to just eat quinoa out of a bowl. I'm telling you to eat food. And when you get creative, your kids should be eating the same thing that you're eating. They should be eating lean proteins, chicken, beef, shrimp, fish. Turkey, whatever they like, right? Proteins. They should be eating vegetables. Of course, you want to make sure you're seasoning them right and cooking them right so that they're appealing. And they're going to want to be eating carbs, some rices, some pastas. I'm sure they like beans and fruit. So all of these foods are foods that your kids eat. You just have to get creative with pairing them together so that it is family friendly. So I just want this lesson to just reiterate how important it is to stay on top of your habits, how important it is to always stay ready when it comes to things that may not come so natural. Because protein, even for me, and I've been doing this for several years, I always have to think about how am I getting in my protein, but I'm thinking about it ahead of time. And people are like, wow, well, you revolve your whole day around food. Well, it's either I think ahead of time and think that what I have to eat later on in my day, or I just don't eat. Me not eating isn't bettering myself. Me not eating is not setting me up for a good day. Me not eating is not giving me mental clarity and helping my body feel what it needs to have energy and to have good moods. Because when you don't have food and you don't have fuel, you don't feel good. So yes, your day should be revolved around how you're going to be moving your body, how you're going to be eating throughout the day. Because when you think of these things, then you get it done. But if you just go through your day and don't think about it at all, it's never going to get done. And there's nothing wrong with thinking and planning ahead for what you need to be the best mom, to be the best employee, to be the best spouse. Because it takes a little bit of effort, but as it continues to create your lifestyle, it becomes easier. And I'm sure that you are doing things now that you never once thought you'd be doing. And now you're 4 months in and you're like, wow, I can't imagine my life without it. Wow, I can't imagine going throughout my day without drinking water. I can't believe I used to do that. I used to be exhausted, right? These are some things that overcomers tell me all the time. Like, Danae, I never used to drink water. Now I drink water and I can't imagine my life without it. Or Danae, I used to never really eat a lot of vegetables, not because I didn't like them, but I just never really cooked them a lot. And these small habits getting added into your day that become routine change your life forever. So this week is all about staying ready with everything that you need to do, with anything that you want to accomplish. This will help you create a better life and feel optimally your best self. And continuously elevate your life. So I'm so proud to see how far you have come. Again, review your habits. See what you're doing awesome in. See what needs a little bit more work and figure out ways to always stay ready. And I'll see you guys soon.